Hi, my name is Stephen Haeg with MTS Systems Corporation. Today I'm going to spend some time talking to you about heavy truck durability testing in the laboratory. Very, very common for tire coupled simulators to be applied to heavy trucks. Simulate the rough road operation that you typically get. They're good for body and box durability testing, chassis and suspension durability testing, durability of frame and chassis mounted components. They're good for ride comfort tests. As a matter of fact, most of the big OEMs for heavy trucks use the four poster for mostly for ride comfort tests. They've moved on from using it for durability because it's not as comprehensive as multi-axial tests. Vehicle NVH assessment is now starting to be done in the heavy truck industry, especially as we get to electric drives where the noises from the truck vehicle, the chassis, and the road become much more perceptively loud to the operators. Buzz, squeak, and rattle testing is also moving into the truck business for the same reason. What are the benefits of these tire-coupled systems? Well, we can run them very early in the development cycle. We don't need a complete vehicle, we just need representative masses and suspensions. We can have quick instrumentation and data acquisition. If we need to get a new drive, we can put accelerometers on the axles and we can drive it around the proving ground, and we've pretty much all it takes. It's very easy to mount the specimen. These are typically drive-on systems where we drive the specimen on and start the run. Very simple drive file generation. You're talking about this vertical displacement control of the actuators. It's as simple as it gets, really. And because the vehicle and the suspension is sitting on the tires on the wheel pan, it generates what we call a quasi-generic drive file. That means if I make some slight changes to the truck, I can put the truck on with the same drives, the same actuator motions, and get somewhat representative durability testing in the laboratory. That saves us time to go out and reacquire data and set up a new test. So four-post tests are considered relatively efficient in terms of throughput. This is an example for some medium trucks. You see here a delivery tractor. We have heavy trucks and off-road vehicles. Here we've got up to 80-ton vehicle with a grain bin on it. We've got tractors, various heavy trucks. I see the movies aren't running. We'll take care of that. So lots of dynamics. We see that, lots of testing. And the tractor testing is primarily for ride comfort studies. The governments in Europe have determined that the tractor seat is a workstation and therefore it has to meet workstation comfort rules, and they have to be certified that way. So there's various four posters in Europe that are specifically used for ride comfort evaluation of tractors. This is an example of testing heavy trailers using a six poster in this case for three axles, and then we've got two channels at the kingpin where the fifth wheel would normally go. They provide vertical dynamic input and torsion to the trailer chassis. So we can test all the attributes of the box, we can do fatigue testing of the suspension and the chassis. This is an example here of thinking through the laboratory design. In order to install the truck here, we wanted to back in with a trailer, or with a tractor, I'm sorry. So we back in the tractor, we park it on its landing gear, we then pull the tractor away, we raise up the kingpin simulator to engage the kingpin, then we raise the whole vehicle up to ride height, and then we start to run the test. When we're done then, we drop the elevator down into the pit, we drive the tractor back in over it, and we can drive the truck back, or the trailer back out when we're done with the test. The elevator and restraint system was patented by MTS and CFM Schiller. Here you see the system in operation. Several of these systems have been installed around the world. This was an interesting off-road vehicle test. It was a tire-coupled test. The customer wanted to run a sugarcane harvester. You see here on the right, typical events. Transport is on the upper part where we're driving across rough roads and things, moving from one field to another. And then you see operation with real harvesting in the bottom, where we're going along what had once been a plowed field. There's various irregularities there. There might be drain pipes and other things, ditches. So these two events are summed together to give us an overall damage environment. So now we want to play these out in a four-poster that's tire-coupled. Well, we've got several things that are going to be challenging. If we look at this vehicle, it's very tall, and it's very short and very narrow in its wheelbase and track width. That means it's probably going to be bad for stability. It's going to want to pitch and roll very easily. Now, one of the other complications we get is we don't have rolling tires. In the field, we have rolling tires that provide a lot of damping to the pitch motion and to the roll motion. We're not going to have those in the laboratory. So pitch and roll will be difficult to stabilize because it'll want to sit there and bounce continuously, which isn't very real on the road because there's damping on the road. So that would mean we'd be limited to our control. We couldn't typically go below about 3 or 4 hertz. Well, when we took a look at the fatigue damage versus frequency on the rig, we see that we've got fatigue damage content cleared down to 0.8 hertz at 1 hertz. There's some down at 0.3 hertz, but we decided that that wasn't such a high amount. It's 10% of the damage at 1 hertz, and it's very, very difficult to get down below about 0.5 or 0.6 hertz. So we used a target of 0.6 to 20 hertz in the laboratory. We wanted to get this system to run all the way down to 0.6 hertz. Well, another thing we noticed is the whole vehicle's got a bunch of resonances in the pitch and roll and bounce modes about 3.25 hertz. We're going to have to stabilize those as well to keep from getting excessive damage. So experience with past tests said this baby is going to bounce, it's going to pitch and roll, we're not going to be able to control it. So what are we going to do to stabilize this system to accomplish getting these very low frequencies played back on this rig with non-rolling tires? Well, one thing we can do is we can apply stabilizing inputs. Our vertical inputs are a primary input, but the vertical inputs really at the axles are not very sensitive to the rock and roll motion we're going to get in the laboratory. So by putting accelerometers up high on the vehicle, such as at the top of the cabin, on the engine and hydraulic system, maybe up here on the elevator, we can see that it's pitching and rolling very easily. Those transducers are very sensitive to that. So by using tools within RPC Pro, we can take these inputs, 12 inputs from all these accelerations, and combine them with the 4 vertical primary inputs, and then we can have only 4 outputs. And those 4 outputs will include stabilizing effects on the pitch and roll that we're going to see that'll be excessive in the laboratory. Doing that, 12 inputs and 4 outputs, is some of the MTS secret sauce included in RPC. Here we can see the results, very good control stability to 0.6 to 20 hertz overall. We edited the data to retain 80% of the fatigue damage to try and cut the test down to 2 weeks. There were some issues of longitudinal interaction between the tire fitting into these tight-fitting wheel pans. We discussed that. I had wanted more clearance. That will be changed later, but we did get good results. We got a major failure after 2 weeks of running in the laboratory. We were a little concerned about that because the customer was coming in the next day, but when he came in and looked at the failure and looked at what we'd done, he said, that's the same failure we saw after 6 months of operation of the prototype in the field. You guys got it done in the same mode in 2 weeks. That's a 10-to-1 time compression and a significant savings on the part of the customer. He was very pleased with the test.